Welcome to Jesse's Flying, and today let's find out how the different macOS, Big Sur and Monterey versions affect the speed of your hardware. So I did a lot of benchmarks lately to find out if the different macOS versions, and if you're using a patched macOS or an open core version, and with open core if you're using your original hardware ID or if you're spoofing maybe a newer hardware, how all these settings affect the speed of your hardware with the macOS. So I put my Mac Pro from 2012 through a number of benchmarks that are age appropriate and the newest versions. The age appropriate ones are the Unigine Heaven 2009 and Unigine Valley 2013, as the Mac Pro is from 2012. That gives a nice overview with age appropriate benchmarks. And on top, you see the different colors for the different macOS versions, either if they are patched, that is the blue one, or if there's OpenCore 069 or 073. And the first three rows represent macOS Big Sur 11.2.3. And you see there's nearly no difference that the bars represent the frames per second in this benchmark. And the next one, the orange and the red ones, are macOS Big Sur 11.5.2 and macOS Monterey Beta 7. And you see there might be a very gradual decrease in frame rates with the Unigine Heaven, but in Valley it doesn't even matter that much. So there's just very few differences between these benchmarks. But if you spoof the Mac Pro 5.1 as a Mac Pro 7.1, that's the last three rows, it doesn't matter if it's 11.2.3, 11.5.2, or Monterey, the performance nearly decreases in half. So from around 105 to 110 frames in the Unigine Heaven, it falls down to 50-55 frames. Same in Valley, from a little bit over 60 frames, it goes back to 30 frames. That's half the performance only because you spoof Mac Pro 7.1. And what's not on this sheet here, I already tried this spoofing a Mac Pro 6.1, same results. The next actual benchmarks that I did was the Geekbench 5 for Mac and the Cinebench R23. And you see here the single core performance, and this is very old CPUs, they are from 2012. So same picture here, it doesn't matter if you use a patched 11.2.3 or an open core 11.52 or an open core Monterey, the performance nearly stays the same. But as soon as you spoof a Mac Pro 6.1, which is not on that chart, but the same behavior, or a Mac Pro 7.1, it decreases in half. So it falls down in the single core performance with the Geekbench from 650 down to a little bit over 300, and in Cinebench from 570 around down to 260 score. Same with multi-core. You see, it didn't change a lot. The first five rows are at nearly double the performance than the last three, which is the spoofed Mac with a multi-core. And last but not least, I checked with the Geekbench the Metal and the OpenCL performance. That's graphics performance, only graphics performance. And here you can see it's just a little bit going around the 50,000 score with a Metal and around the 45,000 score with an OpenCL. But there's no real trend obvious here, so it more or less doesn't matter what you take. The graphics performance remains. So when we go back, we see with a CPU performance only half than with a non-spoofed Mac Pro. That is the reason why the Unigine Heaven and Valley performance decreases also, because it's a combination, it's a game gaming performance, it's a combination of GPU, the graphics card, and the CPU. And so we can say that spoofing a Mac Pro to 6.1 or 7.1 reduces your CPU power to half.